almost 70 miles an hour free of flight out since October.
And in Ohio, they're praying for anything to win. After a truck carrying human waste to a landfill began to leak on a highway west of Columbus, 13 cars went out of control in a 3-mile-long slip. Three northbound lanes were closed for about 4 hours. The company that owns the truck blames a hydraulic valve. Hot lights have been set up to tell people how to clean their cars.
Next in sports, more on the passing of Redskins owner Jack Kent and the Mets in baseball. The Orioles' Roberto Alomar is back in action after serving his suspension for last fall's spinning incident. Ken Drew is next with sports.
Get a jump on spring and watch your savings multiply. It's Stroud's annual spring sale. An overwhelming selection.
Good job, Claire. Are you safe in the lifeboat now? Medicine. You know what they say the best medicine is, Claire?
What?
A cold bath and then going to bed. Fussing, are we? Seemed like when you guys were younger, you always used to cry and fuss in the morning. But then we learned to eat before we got dressed, didn't we? So that made things better. We having waffles again for breakfast?
Yes!
Do we always have waffles for breakfast?
No.
Almost always?
Yeah.
Yeah?
One time we had pancakes.
Yeah. Sometimes you've had cereal.
My eye is rubby.
Let's go see your eye, Claire.
Ooh.
Does that hurt?
My throat is hurting.
My back is hurting. So I'm standing on my tippy toes.
Very well. can't see.
Well, we're going to go to the doctor soon and get your eyes looked at, Claire.
My eyes. Wow.
Okay, guys, say bye-bye.
But my mother's not coming, so he can take.
Hi, George.
Why is my mother not coming? Because there was something going on at the museum. She had to go.
Feel free to come sit on the floor up in front. That's what it's for.
Today has been helping the children with their costumes, and Miss Ross has been helping with their sets, and we've all been learning our songs and our parts and designing our costumes, and I have to do absolutely nothing except get up and say hi, so it looks to me. We're so lucky because we have Mr. Fudd here. Mr. Fudd, can you wave? And Mr. Fudd is from the Rainforest Tribe, the Yanomami Tribe, and he's going to read our play for us. So I'm going to sit down and let him do that.
Once upon a time, almost every good story starts this way. Two people are walking through the rainforest.
Hi, my name is Fred.
Hi, my name is Gladys.
Here's the story of a man named Bradley who was walking through the forest one fine day. He was hiking with a girl named Gladys. It was the month of May. Here's a story of lots of animals who were out in the forest seeking lunch.
Hi, I'm a macaw.
One bird
Get up in the morning, what do they say? When birds get up in the morning, they all say, "Hey, hey, hey." Tweet, 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 that is what they say. Tweet, 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 that is what they say.
The wind was fierce, so she decided the bat might be a good place to rest. She asked Fernando,
"Can I come in?"
"Yes, you may."
So she did. Next, the monkeys came by. They were very lively and curious. They loved their rainforest home, even in the rain. But they were curious.
I wonder what this is.
I just don't know.
Lots of little monkeys jumping on the ground. They decided not to be around. They crawled in the backpack and scrunched up tight. They were ready to spend the night.
Everyone in the backpack decided they fit just right when a little porcupine appeared.
Can I come in?
No, no, there's really no room.
Nobody was ever very nice to the porcupine quills, you know. He started to cry. Well, the other animals decided to be kind and said,
"Come in, just be careful."
So,
right foot in, out.
Scratched his head.